Good evening, fellow students. My name is Rosa Cruz, and I'm here to talk about recession. First, I want to start by describing what a recession is. A recession is a period of time of reduced economic activity of the business cycle. The U.S.-based National Bureau of Economic Research defines recession as a significant decline in economic activity spread across the economy, lasting more than a few months. Normally visible in real GDP growth, real personal income, employment, industry production, and wholesale retail sales. If it lasts longer than a few months, then it becomes a depression. There are many attributes to a recession, which can include corporate profits, employment, and investments. When the demand goes down, the prices go down, and the or prices can go up, which can be defined as deflation or inflation. If there's a combination of both, high prices and a slowdown in economic activity growth, then it is defined as stagflation. But how do we predict a possible recession? There are many possible predictions to a recession. One possible predictor may be the fall down of at least 10% of the value market, stock market that is. Secondly, the 3-month change of unemployment rate and initial jobless claims. Now, to know how to respond to a recession, let's go to my colleague, Ruben Partner.
There are different strategies that our policymakers can use in order to get us through a recession. Depending on the beliefs of these policymakers, they can either choose to intervene or not intervene. You know, those who choose to intervene can use fiscal policy by lowering our taxes and increasing government spending. This will generate money to pump it back into the economy. They also can use the monetary policy. That's when the Federal Reserve lowers interest rates and providing extra money for the bigger banks to lend out at lower interest. Not a lot of people agree with these policies. As you can see behind us, there's a protest going on, the Federal Monetary Policy. I decided to use this protest for a chance to interview a couple of people and get their perspectives into these policies.
For the Federal Reserve, every time we have any kind of recession, anything, all they want to do is print money, create debt. Basically, when you have a recession in the economy, what's supposed to be happening is the debt that we have. The debt that we have is not supposed to be there. The market is saying it's not there. It needs to be liquidated. What the Federal Reserve does is create more debt. So it's adding, so the debt is not supposed to be there, they're just creating more.
That's like getting a credit card if you owe somebody money. You just get more and more credit cards. Eventually you can't pay them all up. You have nowhere else to
come. And that's their solution to everything. It's more money. Cost of inflation wipes out the middle class. And eventually it's going to cause hyperinflation.
Recession today. The good news is that economic recession doesn't have to bring dejection to all. In fact, people can make smart moves to recession-proof their income, such as, one, controlling your debt. I'm not a certified financial planner. However, I surely know that there's good debt and bad debt, such as credit cards and necessary debt, that is a condo or a home. A credit card is always subject to have a variable rate, right? And they tend to get worse for you when times get tough. So try to avoid those situations. One thing I tell people with a home or condo, that's a necessary debt, right? You might as well have a debt with a tax benefit is the way I look at it. If you have credit card debt, establish a strategy for paying it off. For those with multiple cards, I recommend being most aggressive in paying off the card with the highest interest rate and then moving on to the next card. Once they're all paid, don't use them again. Secondly, save up for a rainy day. You should have an emergency fund to be tapped only for necessities. Once you get in your debt, once your debt is in control, put 6 months to 1 year of funds into a safe and accessible account. That's really how you recession-proof your household and family. For example, if your living expenses are $2,000 a month, then you need $24,000. It takes a while to get that, but you have to start now. If you only have a small cushion, a recession will be very, very stressful, but more importantly, impactful. Three, stop supersizing your lifestyle. I see it everywhere. America is known for extra large everything, from meals to cars to homes. Why not cut back on excess, right? In fact, I find that happiness isn't contingent on where you live or what car you drive. If you're making a big purchase, such as a home, consider whether you really need, for example, a house with 5 bedrooms, right? A bigger house means bigger bills and smaller retirement savings in the long run. Fourth point, take a side job. You can base your job around skills, interests, or hobbies. Hobbies can be backdrop jobs along the way and also prepare you for retirement. So I strongly agree that having a second job of interest is an excellent way of diversifying yourself. Fifth point, stand on different financial legs. Meaning, legs can be the salaries of a husband, wife, investment, portfolio, annuities, bonds, pensions, and real estate, or a home-based business. The trick with respect to financial leg is you want to make sure there are not all reacting to the same thing. For example, Enron is a classic case where someone was working for a company and all their 401k was in company stock. You want to make sure that the financial legs you establish work somewhat independently of one another. Lastly, and away from everything that we just talked about, I'd like to top off our discussion with 4 great recession-proof careers. After all, we're all here for a purpose, right? Think about it. Education, healthcare, accounting, auditing, computer tech, all great careers worth thinking about. And they're all recession-proof. It'll be key, informative, you can embrace it, follow through with it,